Hey everybody, welcome back to Banjo-Kazooie. In this video, we're going to head to World 4. This is going to be Bubble Gloop Swamp. We just have to go over here. I actually previewed this a little bit in the last video. Also, in the last video, I mentioned that this is probably not one of my favorite worlds. I played this the other day, and, you know, just like Clanker's Cavern, it's not as bad as I remember it. There is one Jiggy, and I'm sure most of you that have played this game know what I'm talking about. There's one that's actually pretty difficult. It's optional to skip that one and to get an ability that's unlocked. Actually, not next world, the world after that, World 6, Gobi's Valley. Anyway, there is an ability that you can learn that makes getting this Jiggy a lot easier. But I'm just gonna try to get it without it. I did it the other day, but it took a lot of tries. But I'm just gonna skip ahead if I need to. But anyway, here is Bubble Gloop Swamp. Okay, oh, what's his name? Bottles, he's gonna tell us about the ability that we learn here. Actually, the ability you learn is... Well, I don't know if you call it an ability, but you get access to an item that you can use. Okay, this, actually, I can't remember its name, but it'll tell you in a moment. Except to spit an egg in its mouth. Croctus. There we go. So there are a lot of these Croctuses in this level. Actually, I think there is, what, five or six? But after that line of Croctuses that you spit eggs into, you'll get a Jiggy at the very end. I'll just get all these. Okay, here's Bottles. And this is actually the only new move, ability, whatever you want to call it, that you learn in this world. So, just one. Okay, so now we have access to the boots, and it's pretty funny. Okay, yeah, like you said, that's it for this world. I'll leave that there. Something I noticed last time I played this game in my non-recording file, I think I mentioned this before, but in this version, when you defeat an enemy, they're pretty much gone for the rest of the time that you're in the world until you, like, exit. You know, I honestly do not mind that, but I did notice that it makes, like, each of the worlds, after you defeat all the enemies and stuff, it makes it seem kind of empty. You'll see what I mean in a moment. Well, later on. Wait, do I need this? Yeah, I'll take it. Yeah, those frogs are actually pretty common here. Oh, I almost fell in. We're gonna see more in... A little bit. There's like a variation of them that's kind of dangerous. Okay, here's the first Jinjo. Okay, wait, did I go up here yet? That's just eggs. Yeah, some of these, what do you call these? I cannot remember what these things are called. But when you climb them, some of them will have some items. Some are optional, some are ones that you should get, like notes. But that one just has eggs. We don't need any. I'll go over here. This area is actually pretty big. There's different areas that you can go to here as well. Again, like I said in the previous video, this isn't a speedrun or anything, so I'm pretty much taking my time going through all these worlds and stuff. Okay. There's a Mumbo token there. Alright, let's take this. We're gonna go over here, grab the token, and then, yeah, we'll try to get this one up here, too. Oh, oops. There's just, like, a random egg in the middle here. I don't know what laid this or why it's here, but you're gonna find out what's inside. You just have to attack the little bandage part as Kazooie. Oh wait, have to do this. Okay, that wasn't a surprise, it's a Jiggy inside. But again, I don't know what laid that, maybe a bigger Jiggy. Who knows? Wait, did I get that one up? Okay, I did. Actually, what I should have done first, I should have done this. You want to grab the boots so you can actually go into the water safely. I didn't show this yet, but in the last video, I think I talked about it. If you step into this water, you get hurt. There's piranhas in this water, so it's pretty dangerous to be in there. Oh, shoot. Okay, and if you have the boots and you want to get rid of them early, because, you know, if you notice, they run out when the music kind of stops. Hit X on the Xbox controller and you get rid of them faster. I actually didn't know that until, well, not the first time I played through, but maybe like the third or fourth time I played through this game on the 64, I found that out. I had no idea that you could do that until then. Okay, like I said, this is a big area, so I'm trying to think of what I want to do next. You know what, I'm gonna do this. It's right here. Okay, there's a Jiggy. But we have a limited time to grab it. There's actually a number of things that you can collect here and interact with, but I just recommend getting up there as fast as you can. If you miss a note, it's okay. You can come back for it later. Yeah, I'm gonna skip a couple things. There's a Jinjo over there. There we go. And that's actually not the only timed Jiggy that's in this world. There's actually another one that we're gonna see probably towards the end of this video. Okay, so let's go back and get all the stuff that we missed. Here's a Jinjo. I did skip some notes here, yeah. And there's a Mumbo token. Actually, there's a transformation in this level. We did not have one last time, but in this area, there is another transformation with Mumbo. Okay, here's another Croctus. They actually get progressively faster. Yeah, see, that one has red eyes. I think the first one had green eyes, that one had blue, that one's red, or pink, whatever. Yeah, that's pretty much all the collectibles, so let's go... Yeah, let's go in the middle area. Just watch out when you land here. Okay, so you get attacked by all these. They are actually stronger than the red ones, what we saw earlier. They take two hits to defeat instead of just one. As long as you keep them apart, they're really not that difficult. They're a lot faster than the red versions, too. If you want to cheese this part, you can actually use the gold feather, like the invincibility. But I don't really want to waste that. Especially because, you know, right now we only have... we can only carry 10 gold feathers. Oh, that was the last one. Yeah, that's not that difficult. I highly recommend trying to avoid these honeycombs. Especially towards the end of this level, for the last Jiggy. You're gonna need health in case you mess up. And I probably will mess up. Let's go over here. There's like three different ways we could go. There's like that part with like the huts. The part over there with like that big scary crocodile thing. And then this part over here with the big turtle. He's kind of cute. This is a Tank Tup. Okay, he said he's cold. So you can cool him down. He does... he lets out like this funny sounding noise. Sounds like he's in pain, but... You know, but that was what he wanted, so. Okay, and here's the last one. Okay, we absolutely want that. Okay, he opens his mouth, you can actually go inside his, like, stomach, I guess, or his shell, whatever. Oh! Man, that looked like, solid land, my bad. Oh, that's right. We need boots, and there's some on his shell. So, Tank Top is actually really useful. He's, or helpful, I guess. There we go. Okay, so we can use this to get these eggs. Okay, I'm just gonna end that early. I'm gonna grab one honeycomb here. This island with the dragonfly, that is useful, but later on. Like, we don't have to mess with that now. Okay, well, let's head inside. Okay, we're inside Tank Top Shell. Oh, there's some music notes to get here too. Actually, there's another collectible here, but we're gonna grab it after we're done. And inside here is a familiar face. He looks a little bit different, but oh, there it is right there. that's Tip Top. He was in Diddy Kong Racing, but here he's a lot taller. Like these little turtles, they're about his size from... Well, probably a little bit bigger, but he was a really short character in that game, and here he's actually a lot taller than Banjo. Alright, let's talk to him. Okay, lesson one. I did notice that the notes are different for this one than in my non-recording file. Basically, you just have to imitate the notes that were just played. You have to ground pound on them, but it doesn't hurt them, thankfully. Okay, so it was pink, purple, pink, red, and then the light blue. Okay. Was it pink again? I hope it was pink again. Red. Oh. And then light blue. Okay, I think you can listen to it again. I just want to make sure, because there's like a couple in the middle that I missed. Okay, purple, red, yellow, pink, light blue, blue, pink. Okay. Yellow is next, and then pink, light blue, there we go, blue, oh shoot, was the last one pink or purple? I think it was pink. Nice, okay. Okay, so let's get the Jiggy, and then we can head out. Oh, we also need to get the honeycomb piece. But yeah, it's a pretty nice cameo with Tip Top. I did like using him in Diddy Kong Racing. He was one of the slower characters, but he also had really good acceleration. I think he was second after Pipsy. Is that her name? Pipsy? She was a mouse. But yeah, we are done here, so let's head out. Okay, and I think we're actually done in the Tank Top area here, except until later, when we have to go that dragonfly part. Okay, we're gonna save most of that for the end. So yeah, let's go over here. Actually... Yeah, we can't get some of the stuff here yet either. But I'm gonna get what I can for now. But yeah, like I mentioned earlier, there is a transformation in this level. I do recommend waiting until the end to get that one, because there's some like notes, and there's like I think one Jiggy that requires you to be in that form. But it's more convenient to, you know, get everything done as Banjo and Kazooie before you transform, because otherwise you're gonna have to, you know, do some backtracking and stuff. And getting to the area where you transform, it can be kind of annoying. If you're Banjo and Kazooie. Okay, there's the witch switch. We're gonna deal with that after we're done this level. Actually, you have to go to another area of Gruntilda's lair in order to get that Jiggy. Okay, I wasn't sure if it was the left one or the right one, but it's a good thing I went this way. Okay, so we have a Mumbo token, and here's another, oh gosh, I forgot his name already. There we go. But yeah, it's a good thing that I've been, you know, spinning the eggs at those, Croctus, that's what it is. Because if that one wasn't activated yet, there would be nothing here, so I'd have to come back over here. Okay, this is the last hut. You can probably guess what's in here. Okay, that's Jiggy number 6. And I think that's all we can do here right now. I mean, you can get some stuff, but it's better if you get all this stuff as the transformed Banjo. So yeah, we'll come back. Okay, I actually didn't mean to jump on that. Okay, where am I at? 57 notes. Okay, let's go over here. You can actually go inside this crocodile statue. I think it's a statue, because it doesn't... Yeah, it doesn't move or anything. It doesn't blink. Well, whatever it is, yeah, you can actually go inside, but you can't go in until you're transformed. Yeah, inside the nostril, there's actually a little doorway, but you can't fit in there as Banjo and Kazooie. So we'll come back to that. Oh, you know what? Yeah, let's do this now. Because I'm probably going to forget if I don't do it now. Look at this dragonfly trying to attack me. Actually, that's where Tank Top is. Okay, I think I can reach... Yeah, there we go. I think there's some notes on one of these. Yeah, that one there. That has gold feathers. Do I have 10? Oh, I have 9. I'd rather not risk my safety to get those gold feathers. Okay, we're gonna get these 3. Oh, you know what? There's a gold feather right there. I missed. Okay, I think it's just easier to do that. I was gonna try to do the ground pound thing, but he's moving around too much. Yeah, you know what? I think I might have to transform to get those, because I don't see any boots nearby. I mean, there might be some, but yeah, it's probably just easier to do that. I'll wait. I'll come back to those. I hope I remember them, because they're like in this corner with nothing, you know, over here. Okay, like I said, if you have full health, don't even grab those honeycombs. I mean, it's not good to do anyway, but you'll definitely need those later on. Well, maybe. I will definitely need those later on. Oh, shoot. No! Oof. I'm in a really bad spot. Okay, well, I left that honeycomb box alone, so... Let me open this up. I didn't think he was gonna get that close to me. Okay. We're good. So yeah, if you transform, you can actually go in here and... Oh man, I hope I have all the notes I can get. I think I do. I mean, there's a bunch that you get in this maze. But if you're transformed and you want to go... Mumbo's Hut is over here, by the way. You can just take the shortcut. But if you're Banjo and Kazooie, you have to go through the maze. The only thing about this maze is... The camera angles in here are kind of annoying. If you notice, some of the notes that are hidden here, you can't really see them. Well, some of them you can, some of them they're kind of difficult to see. Okay, but yeah, like I said earlier, I hope I got all the notes that I could as Banjo and Kazooie. So otherwise, I'm gonna have to go back to Mumbo, transform, and then, transform back, I should say. Okay. We saw one of these before. This one is more difficult. It doesn't help that the camera angle here is not very good either. Okay, this one we have to be kind of quick with. Oh man, I used to have so much trouble with this one as a kid. Oh, okay, I thought I was gonna fall there. But yeah, you do need to skip over like part of that, I guess this little bridge here, in order to get that. I think you might be able to run the whole way, or if you're brave enough, run as Kazooie, but I've never been able to do that, so. We did get that one, so we're done. And we can move on to Mumbo's Hut. Whoa. Watch out for them, because they like to attack you when, yeah, like that. So cheap. There we go. Okay. This was hidden back here. There we go. You could see it on your way here. There's a gold feather, too. Oh, I was full. I forgot. Okay, well, let's go inside. Okay, you only need 10 tokens, but we have more than double that. Oh! There you go. If you need another one, there's one behind him. Come on, get up there. There we go. Okay, so let's try to get this. There we go. Yeah, you know what I just noticed? In this level, they give you red feathers, but there's nowhere to fly here. You actually don't have the ability to fly in this level at all. Okay, and here's the transformation. You're a little crocodile? Alligator? Yeah, that's a pretty good joke. Okay. Let's take the easy way out. And oh yeah, I need to go over here. So when you're the crocodile or alligator, whatever, I can't remember what you're supposed to be. There is a difference. I guess? Oh no, I'm not even gonna say. But anyway, you can hit the X button on the Xbox controller and you'll do a chomp. You can attack enemies with it and eat things with it. You're gonna have to eat things in the, well, it's gonna be the last Jiggy that I get here. Last one? If not the last one, it's gonna be close to the last one. The only thing is you move kind of slow, but you can move through the water without getting hurt by the piranhas. I guess they just leave you alone. You know what? I just realized I made a mistake. I should have gone behind Tank Top, and yeah, there it is right there. Shoot. Oh well. I'll just have to deal with that at the end. Wait, where? Oh, you know what? Over here. So yeah, like I pointed out earlier, you do need to be the crocodile, alligator, whatever, for this part here. Because Banjo can't fit under here. At least I don't think he can. I've never tried it, but I don't think he can. Okay, there's the last Jinjo, so we have another Jiggy. Gosh, the camera angles here are not that great. Ah, man, it keeps like rotating. Yeah, I'm not even doing that. That's the camera on its own, moving on its own. Okay, you know what? That should be all the notes that I can get before I head into the crocodile head. Yeah, I think there's six in there. Like three on one side and three on the other. In terms of Jiggies, I think it said I had eight. I know one is from the crocodile egg shooting thing. I forgot their names already again. And then the other is inside the crocodile head. So, I think that's where I'm gonna go. Okay, like I said, you can actually go here later and it's a lot easier. It's a lot easier. Emphasis on that because, okay, so there's a mini game that you play in here. There's three stages of it. The first stage is super easy. The second stage gets you know, kind of tough. The third stage for me is, to me, I think it's luck-based. I mean, there's some skill involved too, but you'll see what I mean in a moment. Okay, well, first off, let's get the rest of the notes that we need. The other nostril has the rest of the notes. Okay. So, over here, that's Mr. Vile. I hate this guy. I hate his voice. I hate, like, the things he says. He's just really annoying, too. But anyway, if you see behind him, there are these, like, running shoes. You don't get those until World 6? Yeah, 6. Because the next one's the Ice World. World 6 is the desert, and you unlock that ability there. And basically, it temporarily makes you run faster. And it's super helpful here. But let's just get this over with. Like I said earlier, this is probably going to take me several tries. I'm just going to skip ahead to the... after this attempt. I'll skip ahead to the successful attempt. Okay. So we have to eat the red Yumblies. They look like tomatoes. The red ones look like tomatoes. With like eyeballs on them. There you go. But yeah, the goal is to eat more than him. But the thing is, the computer... Mr. Vile has more of an advantage than you do. Basically because he knows where they're going to spawn and stuff, so he'll go after them at those spots. And I'm messing up really bad here. I mean, there's actually really easy ways to do this. I kind of just eat what I can. But there's some tricks. Like, there's one where you go after the Yumblies that he's eating only. This stage is actually, it's pretty easy to do that because he moves so slow. In stage 2, he starts moving fast. In stage 3, he moves really fast. He moves way faster than you can. Yeah, that's why the running shoes are kind of recommended. If you want to save yourself the trouble, because you move a lot faster with those. Okay, so I beat him by 3. When I did this the other day, I beat him by 5 in the first stage. 2 in the second stage, and then 1 in the third stage. Okay, so now we have yellow ones that we have to avoid. We only eat the red ones, but we have to avoid the yellow ones. The yellow ones are... you can tell there's a big difference. They look like snakes. But they're the unripe ones. Ah, I thought I got that one. But yeah, if you eat the yellow one, I think it stuns you temporarily. If you eat one, then it's pretty much over for you. I mean, you could probably come back from it, but the odds are pretty low. Look, see, he's moving right towards that. He knew where that was going to spawn. Or, like, right when they spawn, he can see where they are. Because for us, the camera... I don't think you could zoom in. Oh, shoot. It also helps to go after ones that have something close by, so you can get, like, 2 or 3 in a row. Got kind of lucky there. Also, I think he's programmed to go easy on you when you're behind. So if you're ahead, he's actually a lot more difficult. At least, that's what it seems like, because in the third stage, usually... I get ahead by like 3 and then he catches up super quickly. Okay, this is the third stage. Like he said, you have to eat only what's on the top screen. If you eat like a the other color, no matter if it's red or not, you get stunned. So, or something like that. I think you get stunned. Okay, switched over to yellow. Of course, all the yellow ones retreated. No. Oh yeah, that also is something that's annoying. If you try to bite one by going up to it and there's nothing there anymore, then you're biting the air and it actually slows you down. Oh, yellow. Okay, switch up to red. But yeah, the shoes actually help out a lot in stage 3. They're actually kind of unnecessary in stage 1. Stage 2, it helps, but they're not necessary again. Stage 3, it helps out a lot. Because if you notice, he's moving a lot faster now. Oh. Oh, I beat him! Oh my god! I beat him! Okay, I've never done that before, like three in a row. Usually I fail that one. Like the first couple attempts. I guess because it helped that I was playing the other day, so I kind of, knew a little bit more what to do. You know what? Actually, I feel like when I was playing the other day in Stage 3, our scores were way higher than that, because I think I beat him 19-17. When I beat him that last time, our scores were, it was like, upper 20s. Yeah, I don't... that's awesome. I really hate that Jiggy too. That's like the worst part of this stage for me. It's definitely challenging without the shoes. But, oh, wait. I need to transform again. Yeah, I really wish I did this before I transformed, because that should be the end right there. That's what I usually do, but I totally forgot about the golden crocodile, so let's do that real quick. Well, as fast as I can, because I move really slow in this form. Then after that, we'll head out, because we're done. Yeah, thankfully you can take this shortcut. I'm so glad that this is there. Well, I guess it's not all bad. I mean, I can actually get out of here as Banjo and Kazooie. But yeah, I would have preferred ending this level with that minigame. I was glad I got it over with. Oh, by the way, I kind of messed up. It's kind of late for this, but, because I think I mentioned it, like, two or three videos ago. But I was talking about how you have to go back to, certain worlds in order to get certain jiggies. That actually only happens once, and that's in, actually, the next world. You need the running shoes for a, certain jiggy. And I think that's the only instance where that happens in the game. I think I said it happens a couple times, or, like, a few times, but, you know, the one here, it's optional. As I showed there, you can actually beat that minigame without the running shoes. But, it, you know, it just helps out a lot. But in Freeze Easy Peak, which is the next world, you have to have the running shoes in order to get one of the jiggies there. Okay, I kind of wish I had knocked him out before, but okay. Oh, that's the last one. Okay, you know what? I felt like there was one more, but I guess not. Okay, we are done with this one. I got all 10 Jiggies, all 5 Jinjos, all 100 Music Notes, and then the 2 Honeycombs. I think there's only 2. I hope there's only 2 here. Because those are the only 2 that I remembered. The exit is over here. Oh, shoot. But yeah, like I mentioned earlier, you know, I used to not like this world as a kid. I guess now that I'm older and, you know, have played this game a couple times. Oh, I forgot about that token. Anyway, I guess now that I've played it a few times, it's not as bad as I remember it. Just like Clanker's Cavern, I mentioned I didn't like that world. But I like it a little bit more now. I remember not liking the ice world more than this one, because there's, I think, 2 or 3 Jiggies to get in that one that are actually kind of difficult. Well, they were difficult for me as a kid, so if it was too difficult back then, you know, I've beaten this game so many times, but those would be Jiggies that I just didn't like getting, basically. Okay, did we go in here? Yeah, I think I talked to her already. I mentioned this earlier, but I'm gonna have to, like, go through these videos and write down the clues that she's given us. Because, as I mentioned, in my other file, she tells me different things, so I'm gonna get them mixed up if I don't do that. But anyway, these boots actually last longer than other ones, because you have to go from that point all the way through here. Okay. That actually takes us over here to the picture for Freezeezy Peak. Okay, and that's actually the next world that we're going to head to, but before we do that, we do have some unfinished business with Gruntilda's lair. We have a Jiggy to collect, and actually I have some other stuff to open up too. We can't head through there yet. I think you have to be transformed or whatever, so you can't fit. But if you need a gold feather, there's one there. Okay, to go back, you need the boots, and they're not completely visible. They're actually on top of the exit here. These ones do not last as long as the ones that we picked up earlier, because you basically make it to the entrance of Bubble Gloop Swamp, so you do kind of have to hurry up. These are running out already. Oh, I made it! Okay. I was in the water, but I guess I got out fast enough so that the piranhas didn't bite me. Anyway, yeah, let's head out this way. I was trying to remember where I was supposed to go, but yeah, let's go this way. Okay, well, let's take a listen to what Gruntilda has to say. Pigsty. Biggest butt competition. And what is this? Ew. Okay. Actually, if you go in the water, there's like this big piranha. Or whatever. You can actually kill him if you want. You can just poop eggs on him. There you go. He yells really loud, too. He sounds like a person. Okay, this is the Jiggy that we can get, but we have to drop down into it. For the longest time, I couldn't figure out, when I was a kid, I couldn't figure out how to get that. But let's head to the next area of Gruntilda's lair. Okay, you need 260 notes to open this, but I have 400. 100 in each of the four worlds that we've been to so far, so that was easy enough to get in here. Oh, these guys. These guys are faster than the red versions, but they die just as fast. Okay, this thing... this is there pretty much forever. The only thing is, when you go in this area, you hear this disc running around. It's kind of loud. But yeah, there's no way to get rid of it. There we go. Okay, and before I end this video, let's explore that part of the lair a little bit. I'm not going to go too much into it because that area features... Well, actually, it features World 5, which is where we're going to go to next, and it also has World 6. I can't remember if it's Gobi Valley or Gobi's Valley. I mean, it doesn't really matter, but... let's see... Oh! I saw this earlier, but I didn't grab it. Let's grab it now. Okay, this is where World 6 is. You don't want to go in there yet. I think you need boots to get in there anyway, but we don't have access to those yet. I mean, well, we have access to the boots, but not the ones that'll help us to get over there. Okay, here's another part of the lair. Okay, these spider webs just spit eggs at them. Okay, we've seen these before. We've actually activated the second one, so we can pretty much warp from that one at the beginning of the lair to this point here. Yeah, this is actually right near the picture for World 2. Okay. Hey, guess what? I forgot something. So, I was editing this video, and I was watching it, and I was like, wait a minute, there's something that I pointed out that I didn't get to, in this video. So it's a good thing I caught that before I started recording the next video, because otherwise my Jiggy count would have been off and I would have started that later. But anyway, we're going to transform, so I'm just going to cut ahead real quick. Okay, we've transformed again, and what we need to do is stay as this form and actually leave this world in the same form, which I totally forgot about. So let's get out of here. Okay, now what we need to do is walk through here. I just skipped ahead because takes forever as the crocodile. Anyway, we broke this earlier in this video, and this is actually how you get through in this form. Now, this is totally optional, but I would probably recommend going through here anyway. Okay, this is Cheeto. Now, he's not like a snack, he's a spellbook that Gruntilda lost. So, there's two other Cheetos in this game, and they all raise the amount of a certain item that you can carry. In his case, it is the blue eggs. So, like he said, we need to go to Treasure Trove Cove and go to the Sandcastle area and put in the code blue eggs, and we'll have the ability to carry more eggs. So, again, I'm gonna skip ahead and we'll get that cheat ready. Okay, we're back here again. We're actually going to take a few trips back to this world so we can put in more codes. Oh, we still have to drain this. Okay, there we go. Thank you, Leaky. Actually, that's what happens when you drain the water with the mine still there. I think when I played through this world, I got rid of the mine before that happened. But anyway, here is the sandcastle. And yes, you do have to do this every single time. Oh, and you have to defeat him too. Well, I guess you don't have to, but it's more annoying if he's around, so. Whoa, that was weird. Okay, so let's put in the code blue eggs. Oh, also, if you go back to Spiral Mountain and go into Banjo's house, you can actually play a mini game. Wait, put that in there. There we go. You can play a mini game. It's like a puzzle game. I'm not going to do that now. I'll come back to that later. Actually, that'll probably be like in a bonus video because, well, we'll see what happens. There we go. Now we can carry 200 eggs instead of 100. So, again, it's totally optional, but, you know, it's definitely worth having. Okay, we're pretty much done here, so let's get out of here. Okay, and now we are done in this video. Yeah, I totally forgot about that Cheeto. I did want to cover it in this video, but again, I totally forgot. It's better late than never, I guess. Okay, in the next video, we're going to head to the next world, which is the one I pointed out earlier, Freezeezy Peak. Alright, everybody, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Mm-hmm.